Welcome everyone to this very special Facebook Live event. I'm delighted to say that we have with us today the wonderful, renowned talking book illustrator Alan Lee, who's going to be here drawing five very special pencil illustrations requested by you. Alan's already begun to draw a figure of his own choosing, and this is Galadriel. Alan?
I think it's Galadriel,
And where do the ideas for the faces come from? Is it from people you know, or is it your own imagination as you read the text?
It just comes from this, putting this on the paper. So, that's where the... just kind of see what happens, really. Just create a little line, a little movement, and it may want to be a nose, it may want to be an eyebrow, it may want to be the branch of a tree. But I draw very intuitively, and so what you get is what you see, literally.
So basically, you're just following your pencil.
I'm just following, just watching to see what my pencil does.
To see what comes up. Excellent. Well, I'd like to say we're having some wonderful comments already, and thank you for those suggestions. It's really helpful. Let's see who we've got here. We've had a suggestion already for a drawing of Thorin Oakenshield. How do you feel about drawing the great dwarf lord?
I like my pencil.
Excellent.
Okay. So, starting with the eye, try and get something to see. Character.
Do you think of his personality, so you think he's fierce, and therefore that informs the eye?
Well, you're just thinking probably of a moment. Perhaps he's looking a little bit suspicious.
Distrustful.
Wondering what this guy is doing with his pencil. In the book, he's a little bit older, I think, and a little bit more rugged than you see him in the film, so I'll probably veer a little bit more towards our Thorin Oakenshield from the book.
That's a good idea. How do you feel about only having 5 minutes to capture the personality?
It's a blessing. Because it's... I mean, it could be an endless effect. It's actually quite nice having a little deadline. As long as people don't expect, finding all masterpiece. It's just an impression.
I'm sure people would be delighted with 5 minutes of your talent. It's wonderful to see how quickly you can realise that a character on the paper.
You're about halfway, so you've got about 2.5 minutes.
The question is, has he still got his hood on, or is he taking it off? I think maybe it's he's just kind of thrown it back casually. Definitely Thorin as a kind of a wandering figure out in the Shire, out in the wilderness somewhere, rather than at home in Erebor.
So he's the king in waiting in this picture.
Yeah.
1 minute left.
This reminds me of those live drawing classes where you have 5 minute poses. Fortunately, it isn't a live drawing class, otherwise we might find out too much about foreign. more than we need to know.
Okay.
Right.
Done.
Fabulous. That's amazing. Well done. So one person, one lucky person, is going to win this very special pencil illustration. We'll be selecting the names later, and you'll be hearing, and we'll be posting the results on Facebook. So keep an eye out for your winning name. Excellent. So. Dwarfs to elf, maybe to elves, I think would be a good thing to do. So, shall we choose an elf? And let's see what names we've had come through on that. Yeah, how about a young Elrond? That would be an interesting idea. This has been selected by, let's see who that was. That was Louise Denning.
Okay.
Aside from the lack of beards, do you feel there's a characteristic that makes it easy to differentiate the drawing of an elf from a dwarf?
It's quite a lot of difference. Not just in the height, but also the character. I don't think an elf would like to be mistaken for a dwarf.
No, certainly not.
2 minutes to go.
Oh, really? Oh, this is good. Time is flying.
Seconds. 3, 2, 1.
Switch to another of the peoples of Middle Earth here. We've had a suggestion to do an old Bilbo returned to Bag End.
Okay.
How about that?
We might not see that much of Bag End.
No, but as long as there's an old Bilbo.
His eyebrows will be even bushier than when he was younger, though.
Alan, we've had a question. Who is your favourite character from Middle-earth to draw?
Fortunately, we have had that as a suggestion, so maybe we can make that the next portrait you do. He looks like he's carried a heavy load.
Yeah, it's kind of the end of a long journey. So it, I guess he's just returned and soon kind of passing on and moving on to the Grey Havens.
It is remarkable how you can capture a faraway stare.
Oh, I've been developing my own fireworks stare for a long time. still got those distinctive hobbit ears.
Had you decided before any of the films how much of a point to give the hobbit ears? Was that ever a big consideration when you were first illustrating?
I always try to keep them looking as normal as possible.
Yeah.
Didn't actually think. I mean, I think the only kind of slightly interesting thing is the word hobbit kind of implies the word rabbit as well. So,
yeah.
The underground dwelling personality that has this kind of longish furry feet, and it just that slight. It's in the language, in the word, but it's also slightly in the character, kind of padding around the countryside.
Mm. 2 minutes to go.
And
they live in hole in the ground. They do. This particular hobbit does.
Yeah. And I think, you know, he hasn't trimmed his ear hair for a while. Cloak, because he's just returned from his travels.
Probably feels the chill.
Yeah. Oh well. Quite okay. Like to spend a little bit longer on these ones, but never mind.
A couple of seconds and then we're done.
Well, no. I think we had three male figures. Let's turn to someone the fairer. So it's from Middle-earth. Should we try a pale? How do you feel about that?
Okay. How do I feel about the heroin?
Yeah. Artistically.
Quite kind of soppy, really.
Sympathetically. She gets a...
Okay, let's go. Yeah, she's a great character, she's such a strong and yet with fragility at some time. Is that taking my name on the plane?
It is. Jenny Leonardson says she loves how you start each character with the eyes. Is that pivotal and important?
It's a good place to start because if you start somewhere else, you end up putting your guy in the wrong place.
Yeah.
Says it's wonderful watching the characters come to life on the page. How does that feel for you, just being able to bring the characters to life, just to express your own imagination?
That's a hard question, actually. I think it's just a, you know, a magical thing with drawing generally, that with just a few lines you can create the feeling of the character, of the place. Let's have her
so many wonderful comments, just people are really enjoying seeing you illustrate these pictures. I think we could sit here all day and we could wear you out and your pencil to an album. Your requests that are coming through.
Wear me to a nub.
Priscilla Hannon says she absolutely loved your drawing of young Elmont.
Great.
Just under a minute to go.
People such as Adrian May saying how much you inspire them.
It's
heartwarming.
It's lovely. It's lovely to hear people's reaction.
Hemkelman says she loves the old Bilbo drawing. So did I. That's fabulous.
Okay, time's up, sorry.
Okay.
Illustration. I think Luca Nicoletti said this a lot among many people. We'd love to see Gandalf illustrated.
Okay.
Such an iconic figure.
Yeah.
Are you okay with Gandalf?
Okay. Let's go.
Do you have a preferred style for drawing portraits?
Well, no, I just thought of that actually. More or less the same angle every time. I wonder if anyone's ever done an analysis of the preponderance of kind of angles of portraiture. It seems the most kind of classic one.
Whether the artist feels that they have a favourite side themselves, and therefore they're drawing their portraits.
Yeah, it might also be to do with the direction of the cross hatching, which obviously plays a huge part.
Monica Lude says, "Woohoo, Gandalf!" Smiley face. So I think we're pleasing a lot of people with this choice.
Okay, I'm glad you get maps with a smiley face. That would take all day.
Julika Van Dorn said, "Could you ask Alan whose favourite character is story-wise?"
Well, actually, I think it's Eowyn. Certainly in the Lord of the Rings.
Journey, if I may use that overused word, is such an important and pivotal one.
Well, yeah, she plays a very pivotal part in the Battle of the Pelennor Fields, the whole kind of victory against the Witch King, and so on. I like the fact that she kind of, you know, she follows her heart.
So halfway.
Okay. Let's give Gandalf a hat up this time.
Daniel Herman says, which location place-wise you like to go? Is there a particular culture or place in Middle Earth that's most interesting to illustrate?
Well, I did find the whole Rohan culture very interesting because it's connection with the Fang.
One minute left.
But obviously, I mean, the elves, that was quite wonderful. And Minas Tirith, you know, the whole Gondorian.
So distinct.
Yes.
Giving such a rich tapestry of inspiration for the illustrator.
Yeah.
20 seconds.
Oh no. Thomas Dunn said you should get a TV program so you can teach people your craft. Open to offers?
There might be a vacancy. I don't know. I think the secret is just doing it, just spending hours and hours and weeks, just kind of practicing.
Okay. Well, your time is up, I'm afraid. That is amazing.
Okay, just a little bit.